All right, hello everyone, welcome back again. I told you during the last recorded lesson we were going to look at two parts of the Holocaust, and this is the second part, and this is called the final chapter. I will let you know now that a lot of the material in this can be disturbing and upsetting, and but I just want to give you a heads up to that because we are going to talk about some of the violence and some of the very disturbing things that happened to those in the Holocaust. So just to give you a heads up on that, okay? So we have our objectives and standards: examine the policies of the Nazis against certain groups and summarize Hitler's final solution, excuse me. And please take a look at the standards as well. Okay, so we have a vocabulary preview. We have genocide, ghetto, and concentration camp. So think about this. When looking at the vocabulary preview, do you recognize any of these words? Have you seen any of these words before? Whatever the case may be. And again, just make sure you answer this question in the think about this section, okay? Again, you can pause the lesson now and do that, or you can wait till the end if you prefer. Okay, so the essential question is, what was Hitler's final solution? Alright, so by 1939, remember we talked in our last lesson, was that the plan was to get rid of the Jewish people in Germany. And the Nazis will be somewhat successful at this. However, the countries that Hitler had conquered, like Poland and France and Czechoslovakia, they had millions of Jewish in their countries. So Hitler becomes obsessed with this idea of wanting to get rid of the Jewish people forever in Europe. He becomes, you know, concentrated on this. So he calls his final plan, I'm sorry, he calls his plan the final solution. And what it was a policy of genocide, which many of you have maybe seen this word before or heard it before, but is a deliberate way of killing an entire population. Okay, so Hitler is going to focus on eliminating the Jewish population specifically. So again, remember that Hitler wanted to create a superior race of Germans, okay? So to achieve this, he knows he needs to get rid of those he deemed weak or inferior, who he didn't believe should be alive anymore, unfortunately. And they included things and people like gypsies, Freemasons and Jehovah's Witnesses, also homosexuals, the mentally deficient or disabled, the physically disabled, and people who were, you know, very ill, terminally ill. And this also included, the people of the Jewish faith, communists, socialists, liberals. Again, liberals are more people, you know, not so like what we think of today, like, you know, Democrats, United States, but liberals who, you know, were more open to different people and ideas, or anyone who just even stood against the Nazi Party, anyone who was not willing to accept Hitler and his beliefs. So Hitler began this whole idea of his final solution in Poland, okay? He had these groups, groups called security squadrons, or the SS, and they would round up Jewish men, women, children, and babies and execute them right on the spot. Another thing that Hitler did was the Jewish people were also forced to move out of their homes, and they were forced to move to areas called ghettos. Now, these were areas like neighborhoods that were sealed off with barbed wire and stone walls. It was overcrowded. The living conditions were terrible. And many of the Jewish were forced to work in Nazi factories to help support the war effort. So many of them were forced to work in these factories that were persecuting them. And here's a picture of what one of the ghettos looked like. You can see, you know, the word there, ghetto, and, you know, Nazi soldiers. And I'm not sure if this is looking in. I believe this is looking into the ghetto instead of out. But you can see just what they looked like, the barbed wire on top of the fences and how it was blocked off pretty much, and the German Nazi soldiers keeping an eye on thing. Now, despite the fact that, you know, these Jewish were persecuted, some of them did resist to the tactics of the Nazis, okay? They formed secret groups of resistance. There was a movie a couple years ago, it escapes my mind right now what the name of it was, but it focused on a group of Jewish people who escaped and lived in the woods and actually fought back against the Nazis for a duration, mostly during the war. It's a good movie. And again, if I remember it, I'll try and tell you later, but it's escaping my mind right now. Other ways they fought back was they published their own newspapers or set up music and theater groups. They still want to be entertained, so they still, celebrate their own culture in their own ways. And some even sent their children to secret Jewish schools so their children could still be educated in the Jewish faith. Right, concentration camps. So those Jewish who were not reached by the death squads were taken from their homes. They were put on trains or trucks, and they were sent to concentration camps, which were basically labor camps. People were jammed into wooden barracks that were overcrowded, and hunger and labor killed many of these people. Okay, they were pretty much worked to death. There was not a lot of food. They were beaten. They were assaulted. Horrible, horrible conditions. And again, just things that you can't even imagine. That people could do to other people, unfortunately. Here are some pictures of what on the top left corner there. That's one of the barracks. You can see the beds. Men were men, women. They were separated into men and women barracks. But it was very crammed, very crowded, and things like that. And then the bottom right-hand picture here is a picture of the inside of one of the railroad cars that people were brought to the concentration camps in. Again, they were crowded. It was hot. It was or it was extremely cold. It was just horrible, horrible conditions. There's no words to really describe it. Okay, so the death camps. So in 1942, Hitler's top officials adopted a new method to exterminate the Jewish. Again, they want to get rid of the Jewish, and they're not, sadly, killing them quickly as much as they want to. It's just horrible to think about. But either way, they want to kill these people quicker. So the Nazis built six death camps. Each camp had huge poison gas chambers that could kill thousands a day. So what would happen is when these Jewish prisoners arrived at the camp, they would be forced to parade, most times naked, in front of Nazi doctors who would examine them and separate them into the weak and the strong. The strong were sent to go work and do labor. Again, sadly, the weak or those who they didn't think could do the labor were sent immediately to the gas chambers, and they were, told they were going to go shower. They were pretty much lied to, but they were sent into these gas chambers, and they had shower heads in them. They would lock the people in there, and then poison gas would spray from the shower heads and kill thousands and thousands of people. There were also other methods of killing too. There were shootings. There was hangings, there was poisoning, and doctors even did horrible medical experiments on Jewish prisoners, people who were twins. They would, try and experiment on them. They would try and do other just horrible, terrible things to them, and a lot of times people died from these medical experiments. So, an estimated 6 million Jewish people died at the hands of the Nazis. That's from the SS troops. That's from, working in the labor camps. That's from even the ghettos, and that's especially from the death camps as well. Now, some did survive the terrible events, and they would forever remember what they experienced. This woman here, if I'm trying to say her name right, Manya Kornbilt, she was a survivor of the Nazi reign of terror and the Holocaust. In the story I was reading about her, it said that she saw her friends beaten and killed, and everything like that. And it's kind of hard to see, but she's pulling up her sleeve there, and what she's showing you, she has a number tattooed on her arm, and each prisoner was given a certain number, and it was tattooed on their arm, so they could be identified. They didn't really have names in the Holocaust, so they were given numbers instead. So she's showing you her number that she was tattooed with, unfortunately. Okay, but again, many people did survive. Many people resisted, but again, it was a very horrible time for the Jewish, and many of them were executed just because of Hitler and the Germans' beliefs of this this time. And it wasn't too long ago. It seems like it may have been a long time ago, but it really wasn't too long ago that this happened. Less than 100 years ago is when this happened. All right, so just kind of wrap it up here. Okay, so Hitler and his aides used policies to wipe out groups of people. We talked about, the SS squads. We talked about the ghettos. We talked about the labor camps and the death camps. And again, the Jewish were forced to relocate to these ghettos, and some did kind of fight back in different ways, but many were unfortunately killed at labor camps or death camps. And the picture there at the bottom there is the a memorial to the victims of the Holocaust, which is in Berlin now. If you get a chance, look up the website for it. It's the Holocaust Memorial in Berlin. I was doing some research myself on it. It was pretty interesting because I never heard of it. It only opened a couple of years ago. But some of the things they have in there, they have a museum, and it's a nice memorial to those who were lost during this horrific event in human history. Okay, that's all I have for today. So again, just make sure you answer the questions, please, and I will see and talk to you later.